So turning your phone into a webcam in OBS Studio is extremely easy. This is going to work whether you have a Google or an iPhone. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to go to our mobile device and you want to go to this URL right here, vdo.ninja/?push. This is going to go ahead and bring you to a site just like this. You want to select share your camera. It's going to ask you, would you like to allow access to the microphone and camera? You simply select allow, and this is going to instantly go ahead and bring that camera. Now, I encourage you to use your back-facing camera because it's going to give you the best quality. Then, if you plan on using the microphone directly from your phone, then leave it as the audio source. But if you have a microphone that you're going to utilize in OBS Studio, I encourage you to select no audio. Then, on the camera video source, hit this little gear icon. Right now, by default, it's set to high resolution. You can leave it there, but I want to kind of warn you that it's going to create a little bit more of a delay. So I encourage you to instead use smooth and cool, because it's going to reduce the latency that you're going to experience with this. Okay, it's not going to be instantaneously, but it is a slight delay. However, this is a great solution because it gives you a good quality. Then once you've gone ahead and got that set up, you simply want to select start. This is now going to begin to feed that camera. So you can see here that now my back camera is activated. And what we simply want to do here is you want to copy the URL that's in your browser. Once you've got that copied, we want to come into OBS Studio to be able to add it. So in order to do that, you want to come to the scene where you want to add in your phone camera. We're going to come to sources. It's this little plus icon, and we're going to select browser. I'll name this iPhone camera source and then press OK. And that's going to ask me to input a URL. We're simply going to paste the URL that we just went ahead and copied and make one slight modification to it. If you don't make this change, you will not see it. And that's changing the word push to the word view. If you don't do that, you will not see the camera come through. Then for the width, we want to set this at 1920 by 1080. Okay, and then you want to select control audio via OBS. We'll press OK, and now you're going to see here that this camera is going to go ahead and come through, and you're going to see that we're not going to have that much of a delay or latency because we did smooth and cool. Now let me show you how to improve even more the image quality that's produced by your camera. So what you simply want to do is you want to right click on the source. You want to select filters, and you want to go ahead and move that over here where it says filters, and you want to select effect filters. You want to put this little plus icon, and you want to select color correction. You'll press OK. And the few adjustments that I want you to make, so let's take a look here, is I want you to take the gamma and bring it down slightly. That's going to make the image a little bit darker, but it's going to make the colors look a little bit richer. And then the saturation, you want to bring it up just a little bit because it's going to make the colors pop a little bit more. And then the contrast, you want to bring it down slightly because that's going to give you more of a true black color on your blacks. Then you simply press close, and now that's going to give you a great quality image that you can then place wherever you want to. Now, if you decide to go ahead and use this outside of OBS Studio, you need to make sure you come down here to the bottom and select start virtual camera. If you do not select that, you will not see your camera coming into like Zoom or Teams. But if you're going to use it directly in OBS Studio, you do not need to have the virtual camera turned on. But now that you have your webcam from your phone in OBS Studio, how do you make your stream look professional with countdown timers, stinger transition, alerts, and everything you need to create a more engaging stream? Go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on how to do all of that directly inside of OBS Studio. Click that video right there. I'll see you in the next one.